Hey everyone, this is Vignesh from Easy Way to Learn Medicine. So today we are going to see the important CROC 1 questions and discussion from the topic of gout. So first of all, we'll see what is gout. Gout is gout, which is acute inflammatory monoarthritis caused by precipitation of monosodium urate crystalline joints, that is uric acid or uric acid salts, which is accumulate in the joints. So we also call it as podagra, gout or podagra. So the causes is unknown. That we have some risk factors for gout, that is male sex and hypertension, obesity, diabetes mellitus, dyslipidemia and alcohol use. Also there is a strong risk factors that causes hyperuricemia, which has two reasons. One is under secretion of uric acid. When there is like any idiopathic cause or when there is a renal failure, it cannot like excrete the uric acid by the kidney. Or when there is overuse of medications called thiazide diuretics. Also, when there is a overproduction of uric acid. So this is a, like most of the people have like 10% overproduction of uric acid. When there is under production of uric acid, that is a 90% of the patient, that is Leish-Nahan syndrome. In the Leish-Nahan syndrome, there will be a HGPRT enzyme deficiency. So it cannot, like there will be overproduction of uric acid, also like PRPP enzyme excess, or when there is a tumor lysis syndrome, there will be overproduction of uric acid. Also von Gierke disease, that is a glycogen storage disease type 1. So the image now you are seeing is that purine metabolism pathway. So you can see how like uric acid is synthesized. This one is xanthine. From the xanthine, it by the enzyme of xanthine oxidase, that leads to uric acid. So overproduction of uric acid, when there is a high level of PRPP, and also like when there is a deficiency of HGPRT in a Leish-Nahan syndrome. So you can see the short form HGPRT, which is a hypoxanthan guanine phosphoribosyl transferase, and PRP monophosphate. So now we'll see the symptoms. The patient will have like the joint will be swollen, red, painful, and there will be a like metatarsophalangeal joints will be like inflammation, there will be like swelling, we call it as podagra. There will be a tophus formation, there will be like joint swelling, and there will be a whitish substance discharge. So often on a external ear, olecranon brusa and Achilles tendon. So acute attacks tend to occur after a large meals with food rich in purines, for example red meat, seafood, or any other trauma, surgery, dehydration, diuresis, alcohol consumptions that lead to like exacerbate the symptoms. So for the treatment, primarily we'll use non-steroidal anti-inflammatory drugs, that is indomethacin, and we'll use corticosteroids and colchicine. In chronic or in a prophylactic, we'll use uricic drugs. It's to increase uric acid excretion. Also, we'll use allopurinol. Allopurinol, which is a xanthine oxidase inhibitor, which decreases the uric acid synthesis. So now we'll move on to questions. So, which is repeatedly asked in CROC 1 examination. A 46-year-old female consulted a doctor about pain in a small joints in upper and lower limb. The joints are red and enlarged and shaped like thick nodules, that is tophi, and serum tests reveal that there is an increase of urate concentration, that is uric acid salt. This might be caused by a disorder of metabolism of purine metabolism. So when there is a purine metabolism disturbance, that lead to gout. So the next question, the patient is complains of pain in a MTP joints and joint deformation. In a blood, there will be hyperuricemia. An X-ray revealed that MTP joints space narrowing, erosion, periarticular calcification of the joints, osteoporosis. Microscopy revealed that inflammatory granulomatous reaction surrounding necrotizing masses in the area of a first metatarsophalangeal joints. In a gout, most of the time it affects the MTP joint, that is metatarsophalangeal joints, and you can see the tophus also. But in the blood, they told hyperuricemia. There is an increased level of uric acid. So that is gout or podagra. So 52 year old man presented with fever and pain in the joints. Both of his first metatarsophalangeal articulation was deformed, swollen and reddened. Blood urea is high. The patient is diagnosed with gout. What mechanism main development factor in the pathogens of this disease? That is hyperuricemia, increase of uric acid salt. The fourth question, a therapist has an appointment with a 40 year old patient, complains of recurrent pain attacks in the hallux joint and their swellings. Urine analysis revealed its marked acidity and a pink color. This increased pH and a pink color, especially it suggests that there is a presence of uric acid salt. So there will be like uric acid substance seen in the urine. So fifth question, the patient with gout has increased blood uric acid concentration. In order to reduce the level of uric acid, the doctor administered him allopurinol. Allopurinol is a competitive inhibitor of the following enzyme, that is allopurinol with inhibit the xanthan oxidase. So there will be decreased amount of uric acid synthesis. So the sixth question, the patient is suffering from gout, was prescribed allopurinol. What pharmacological property of allopurinol provide therapeutic effect in this case? That is competitive inhibition of xanthan oxidase, that will decrease the uric acid secretion. Also, in the questions like the patient is having Leish-Nyhan syndrome, what enzyme is deficit? That is HGPRT. So that is hypoxanthoguanine phosphoribosyl transferase enzyme deficit or absence. So this is all about the gout. So thanks for watching. We'll continue to next video. Thank you.